Can't let them get to me. And even though I always fuck my life up, only I can mention it.
See, before I let you go, one last thing I need to let you know. You ain't ever seen nothing crazy then. This nigga when he off his Lexapro. Remember that last time in Mexico? Remember that last time the episode? Asking me why the hell I test the code. Four times just to say don't text me, ho. Told you four times don't test me, ho. Then we finna lose all self-control. But you ain't finna be raising your voice at me. Especially when we in a Giuseppe store. But I'ma have the last laugh in the end. Cause I'm from a tribe called Checker, ho. Yeah, I'm out of laugh in the end.
Okay, that makes sense. Okay, that's fine. Just let me know, like, preferably if you could under-eat, that would be a good idea.
Yeah,
alright. Try. Okay, guys, so this has been my lunch throughout this mini cut. High volume, low calorie. You can make it even lower calorie than this. But I'm going to take you through it. I'm going to show you what ingredients I use, and so you can make it yourself. So what we've got in here is a whole packet, yes, a whole packet of iceberg lettuce. Lettuce, Christ. We've got a carrot, a whole carrot. We've got a tin of tuna, any brand of tuna, just make sure it's in spring water. Don't use the oil ones. Why? Just because this is lower calorie. Cucumber, some cucumber. Some mushrooms, which I chop up. A red onion and a pepper. Now, in here, we've got the secret to success. Instead of using like spaghetti or a carb sauce, like rice or potato, I am using butternut squash, which is pre-bought, but it's essentially butternut squash chopped up into the form of spaghetti. It's not spaghetti, so don't hurt me. But it's good because it creates a ton of volume for low calories. So when this is done, I'll show you what it looks like. But these are the secret ingredients. Okay, here we go. Finished product. So here it is. I actually really recommend these butternut squash noodles or whatever they are. I got them from Tesco and I think they're like, for three of them, it's about £2. So it's not like hella bad or anything. And they do actually taste really good. And a lot of volume, obviously, for the calories. I think they're like 80 calories for a packet. But yeah, really decent. Do recommend them. Gonna use some ketchup and some pepper. Gonna eat this, watch a bit of YouTube as I've done most of my client check-ins. And then I am going to train. Cool, see you in a bit. Okay guys, I am really excited to bring you this voiceover over a lower body training session. And I'm gonna talk about what you've just seen, what's happening, and basically, you know, what this series is gonna be about. So, I will be entering a powerlifting meet in 5 weeks' time. It is under the GBPF, so the Great British Powerlifting Federation, and I will be aiming to compete in the under 74 kilos or 163 pound weight category. So at the moment, you're seeing this footage, I am 166-ish pounds. So I'm like waking up a bit between 166 and 168, depending on the time that I get up, what I've eaten, whether I've had a load of food volume from my Morris salads or some crazy stuff has gone on with sodium. So yeah, that's what I'm aiming to do. I'm aiming to get down to that under 74 kilo weight category with losing minimal strength, which has gone well so far. However, some days this week have felt a bit shit, but these things happen. So, that's what I'm aiming to do. I am aiming to get a qualifying total for the British finals in that federation. Whether I do the British finals or not, I don't know. Long-term goals in terms of bodybuilding is more of a priority for me. So if staying under £163 is going to sacrifice my bodybuilding goals, which it probably will do, because I feel like I'm my strongest and my best in like the high 160s, low 170s, where my physique starts to maybe look a bit chubby. But in terms of strength gains, and in terms of how I feel on a day-to-day basis, I feel a little bit better, just a little bit higher in terms of my set point. This mini cut, however, was needed. It is beneficial in both keeping me at the low end of my body fat set point, so I'm in a more optimal place to build muscle moving on in the future. And I'm just going to be, yeah, putting myself in a better position to go through a gaining phase. So that's the point of a mini cut, really. It's just sort of like defluffing, getting the excess fat that you've gained over a gaining phase off, and then going again. So obviously after the competition, I want to go back into a gaining phase, and you will follow that journey. However, now the main goal is to get under that weight category, stay strong as fuck. As you've seen in this video, I squatted 175 for 3, which is a PR, and I got it for 2 sets. And yeah, stay strong as fuck, and basically do as much damage as I can at this meet. I am really excited. I just want to, you know, see what is possible over this sort of 5-week period. I'm going to be basically raising training volume as we get closer and closer, and then I will finally end with a deload, proper deload leading into the meet, and then crush some PRs. So guys, I hope that you are looking forward to following this journey. I will be updating you with what I'm eating, how I'm training, weigh-ins, full day in the life, full day of eating type things to come. I hope that you enjoy it, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching, guys. See you later.